The infamous Supra Mahumapelo, a man whose political career began in the early 80s to manifest to the highest echelons of provincial politics. Since assuming the premier's office in 2014, Mahumapelo has battled to save the party from infighting and factional divisions. The ANC's support base in the province is steadily declining, and some believe it might even drop below 50% if there is no serious intervention. And it seems Mahumapelo's adaptable nature may face its greatest test, as calls for him to step down by opposition parties and some disgruntled members of the ANC and its alliance partners intensify.
Mr. Mahumapelo is also not politically aligned with the forces of the day. At the moment, he is aligning himself still with Jacob Zuma, with Ace Geshule and these people. And I believe that is the wrong position to be in at this time. And I can only see big trouble for him in the future.
While divisions in the ruling party in the province did not begin with Premier Mahumapelo, it seems the party grew more fragmented under his leadership, with major fault lines forming post-Nasrec, as members of the alliance rallied to have him removed from office after his pro-Nkosazana Dlamini Zuma slate lost to the Ramaphosa camp.
As the alliance, we were the capacity to deal with such matters. If we believe that the leader is no longer relevant, is no longer serving the interest of the populace and those that have put him in a position that he is, workers were very clear that the Premier and the Chair of the African National Congress must speak to his conscience and relinquish the position that he is in.
The Premier's name was also brought into disrepute last month when his office was raided by the Hawks after allegations that an IT company, Nepto Data Dynamics, was irregularly paid more than 215 million rand. And his name also made headlines when it emerged that the Premier also had prior knowledge about corruption in the provincial Department of Health relating to an irregular payment of 30 million rand to a Gupta-linked medical technology company, Nidiosa.
In the Northwest, as you would know, government is collapsing. The Department of Health, as you know, is in a state of paralysis. Medicines are not procured, medicines are not provided to our people in the hospital. The health system is in a state of shambles. And all of these things are a reflection of inability to govern.
Our view as SANCO is the national leadership of the ANC, or the led by Comrade Cyril Matamela Ramaphosa, must invoke Section 100 in the administration of the Northwest, because there is no government. Government has collapsed.
While popular for his charisma, it remains to be seen if that alone will be enough to salvage Mahumapelo's premiership. Sintle Inhihi, SABC News, Mahikeng.